Sunny was 11 years her senior. Boy, how the years have changed her love life. That's why Cher comes in at number one.
If I could turn back time. If I could turn back time.
In her 1989 hit, Cher sang it, but in her dating life, she has done it in a very big way.
Age has never been a thing with me, but if I waited for men my own age to ask me out, I would have never had a date my entire life.
23-year-old Val Kilmer was 36-year-old Cher's date to the 1983 Oscars. They met at her birthday party thrown by Silkwood co-star Meryl Streep. Right after Val came Tom Cruise, 16 years her junior. This reunion photo is from 2002.
It was a long time ago, a long, long time ago, and neither one of us ever talked about it. I don't know why, but neither one of us ever talked about it.
Or put it in your book.
No, I loved him, though. Yeah. He was amazing.
It ended when Cher wouldn't join Tom on location.
It was right before The Color of Money, because I couldn't go to Chicago. And that was kind of the straw that broke the camel's back.
That is Rob Camaletti all over Cher's 1987 video for I Found Someone. She has said it was the best relationship she ever had. Rob was 22 when they met in 1986.
The night I met Robert, I just turned 40. I was kicking back at this club that he and I used to end up going to. And I was having a beer and I was thinking, you know, age didn't touch me. I'm about to do this movie. I'm about to do three movies and an album and I'm looking great. And my God, who is that?
The media called him Bagel Boy because he worked in a bakery. Cher didn't care.
If I like you, it's just because it's you. It's all only about you.
But 2 years later, Cher was at an L.A. jail bailing Rob out after he was charged with assaulting a paparazzi outside Cher's home.
I have people who are camped out at my house, who are going through my garbage, who are calling my telephone, and this is a real terrible, unfortunate thing that happened today.
Rob pled no contest, was put on probation, and fined.
We all sleep alone.
The breakup was marked by this hit, We All Sleep Alone. It was co-written by the 13 years younger Richie Sambora, who became Cher's next boyfriend. They moved in together, and he says she was the inspiration for his first solo album.
When we were living together, I would always be singing around the house and playing my guitar or something. That's kind of a release for me, you know. And she said, man, you're good enough to do this. You could go do it. And I said, I don't know. I was really insecure about it. And she was somebody that really, kind of smacked me in the back and said, come on, you can do this. I'll never forget her for that.
Now Cher is 65 and single. Back in 2009, she told me the kind of guy who would catch her fancy.
If they had a motorcycle and they were big and hunky and funny and had a good heart, that's what I'm looking for.
Cher certainly was a clear choice for number one, but we have a whole gallery of Hollywood's older women with younger men for you to check out. All you have to do is visit our website, etonline.com.
Michael Jackson to Britney with LL Cool J to Mariah Carey. Dick was beloved by stars in music, TV, and more. And today, Hollywood continues to mourn. Julia Roberts at the Jesus Henry Christ premiere and stars at the Us Weekly Hot Hollywood Party.
Cyndi Lauper. Bon Jovi.
He not only was a champion of rock and roll music, Dick Clark was a pop culture icon.
I would watch him do all the new dances, and I would just sit there completely in awe. I wasn't quite a teenager yet, but I loved the music.
Ladies and gentlemen, Sonny and Cher.
All I really wanna do is, baby, be friends with you.
I remember when we were doing it thinking, we're on American Bandstand.
So did Gloria Estefan after Dick put the Miami Sound Machine on back in 1986. Today, she talked with us on the phone.
Getting a spot on American Bandstand was the dream of every artist. I grew up watching the show. I was a huge fan. Well, if you, you know, were on Bandstand, you were automatically deemed a success. He was a humble, sweet, very gentle man that wielded all this power with humility and humanity, and it was just an amazing experience.
You're going to change your lives at all?
Probably a lot more busy. Bandstand wrapped in 1989, but of course Dick continued to produce the American Music Awards. Whitney Houston performing I Have Nothing in 1994. Incredible how many superstars were on Bandstand. And here's a trivia question for you. Who